rockets are fundamentally different than the conventional ones that we've been talking about, which are known as chemical rockets. Because instead of creating chemical explosions, they create plasmas.
Space travel has always seemed like a distant dream, something far beyond our reach. But what if there was a way to reach Mars in just 2 months instead of nearly 9?
Shuttling humans between the Earth and Mars in just a few weeks.
Sounds incredible, right? Well, it's no longer just a dream. A revolutionary propulsion system called Pulsed Plasma Rocket could change everything. Let's dive into this groundbreaking technology that could make faster, safer trips to Mars a reality. What is the Pulsed Plasma Rocket? The Pulsed Plasma Rocket is an advanced propulsion system that uses nuclear fission to create plasma bursts, which are then directed to generate thrust. It's super efficient and powerful, much more so than current rocket technologies. This means that PPR can accelerate faster, travel longer distances, and all while using way less fuel than traditional rockets. Now, you might be wondering, why is this important? Well, current space travel systems are slow. A trip to Mars can take anywhere from 6 to 9 months, and during that time, astronauts are exposed to space radiation and microgravity, which can negatively affect their health. The PPR could cut this travel time down to just 2 months, which is a huge leap forward for human space exploration.
A weak plasma rocket can deliver more cargo than a powerful chemical rocket. And as a bonus, it can even get you to Mars faster.
Why is this rocket different? When it comes to space travel, speed and efficiency are key. Traditional rockets, like the ones that send satellites or astronauts to the International Space Station, rely on chemical propulsion. While they get the job done, they're not the most efficient when it comes to long-distance travel. These rockets burn through fuel quickly, which limits how far they can go before needing to turn back or refuel. And let's be honest, space refueling isn't exactly something we can do just yet. This is where the PPR stands out. Its fuel efficiency is way better than anything we've seen before. Instead of relying on a massive amount of fuel like traditional rockets, it uses bursts of nuclear fission to create thrust. The energy released from splitting atoms is used to propel the spacecraft forward at much higher speeds. Sounds powerful, right? But there's one key term you need to understand to really get why this matters. Specific impulse. This is a measure of how efficiently a rocket uses its fuel. The higher the SP, the farther the rocket can travel using less fuel. Traditional chemical rockets have an SP of about 300 to 400 seconds, while the PPR has an SP of 5,000 seconds. This means it can travel much farther with far less fuel. Imagine the difference in how quickly we could reach other planets. You may have heard about other types of space propulsion like ion drives or solar sails. These methods are more efficient than traditional rockets, but they have their limitations. Ion drives are great for deep space missions, but they don't provide the high thrust needed for human missions, while solar sails rely on sunlight and are incredibly slow. On the other hand, the PPR is designed to combine both high efficiency and high thrust, making it perfect for missions to Mars and beyond. And it doesn't stop there. This propulsion system could also make missions to Jupiter, Saturn, and even places like Europa, one of Jupiter's moons, much more feasible. But here's a question for you. Do you think using nuclear energy in space is a good idea? It's powerful, but also risky. Let's think about it. One of the biggest advantages of the PPR is that it drastically reduces the time it takes to get to Mars. Currently, astronauts spend months on a journey to the red planet. If the PPR works as expected, we could cut that travel time down to just 2 months. That means less exposure to harmful space radiation and fewer health risks for astronauts. Plus, a shorter journey means less fuel is needed, making the mission much more cost-effective. It's a win-win. Wouldn't it be amazing if we could send astronauts to Mars and they'd be there before we even had time to miss them? Reducing the travel time to Mars is not just about getting there faster. It's also about safety. During long journeys, astronauts are exposed to galactic cosmic rays and solar radiation, both of which can cause serious health problems like cancer. The faster the trip, the less time astronauts are exposed to these dangers. Plus, the PPR can carry heavier spacecraft. This means extra protection like shielding can be added to the spacecraft, making sure the crew is safe from harmful radiation. And it's not just Mars. With faster propulsion, missions to the outer planets or even moons like Europa become possible. Imagine astronauts exploring these distant worlds without the weight of long travel times. Could this be the beginning of humanity's journey into the outer solar system? How does it work? The pulse plasma rocket works through a process known as nuclear fission, which is when atoms are split to release a massive amount of energy. This energy is then converted into plasma, a superheated gas that can be harnessed to create thrust. In simple terms, it's like breaking apart atoms to unlock a powerful energy source. The plasma generated from this energy is then channeled through a system that helps propel the spacecraft forward. Imagine blowing air through a straw to create a flow, but instead of air, it's high-energy plasma rushing out, giving the spacecraft the push it needs. One of the most interesting parts of this system is the magnetic nozzle. The nozzle has a crucial job. It directs the flow of plasma in the right direction to ensure the spacecraft gets maximum thrust. This is important because the direction and speed at which the plasma exits the nozzle directly affects how efficiently the rocket moves. The better the nozzle, the more thrust the spacecraft gets, and the faster it can travel through space. It's like having a supercharged engine that can be carefully controlled to get the most power from the fuel. But here's the tricky part. The magnetic nozzle has to withstand extreme temperatures and strong magnetic fields while doing its job. We're talking about handling the intense heat from plasma, which can reach thousands of degrees, and the strong magnetic forces that are used to direct the plasma. It's no small task. The nozzle needs to be built tough enough to stay intact and continue guiding the plasma without breaking down, ensuring that the spacecraft gets the thrust it needs to keep moving. To put it into perspective, think about trying to steer a fireball with your hand while keeping it cool. That's the kind of challenge engineers face when designing the magnetic nozzle. It's a delicate balance between handling extreme forces and ensuring efficiency. The result? A system that can produce powerful, controlled thrusts to propel spacecraft to new frontiers in space exploration. Now, isn't that impressive? What's next for PPR? The development of the PPR is moving along. It's currently in phase two of its journey. The first phase focused on designing and testing the basic concepts. Now, NASA and their partners are working on optimizing the engine, building the spacecraft, and conducting more tests to make sure everything works as expected in the harsh conditions of space. During this phase, they'll conduct proof-of-concept experiments, where they'll test the engine in simulated space conditions. This is crucial because they need to make sure the system is reliable and ready for real missions, especially ones with human crews. We don't want any surprises when we send astronauts to Mars, right? Once the tests are successful, the next step is to design the complete spacecraft that will carry astronauts to Mars using the PPR. If all goes well, we could see the first crewed mission to Mars happen within the next couple of decades. What does this mean for human space exploration? The PPR isn't about getting to Mars faster. It's about changing how we explore space. With quicker travel, astronauts would have more time to explore other planets and moons rather than just making the journey. Efficient propulsion could even make establishing a permanent human presence on Mars a reality, with habitats where people could live and work for long periods. This technology offers huge potential for space exploration. By combining high thrust and efficiency, the PPR could dramatically cut down travel times, opening up new possibilities for missions not just to Mars, but to other planets and moons too. Thanks to the PPR, future missions to Mars and beyond could be faster, safer, and more efficient. The dream of exploring distant celestial bodies is now much closer to reality. What do you think? Could this new rocket system change how we travel to Mars and explore space? Let us know your thoughts in the comments.